What is good, guys? No Sleeves 12 here. We are going to discuss the NHL 19 Hut Stanley Cup event that was released today. It's huge. It looks awesome. Let's jump into it. So a basic summary is all of the teams that have clinched received two players, random. Most of them are not the superstars of their team. And they all got 91 overall cards. Now, the thing about these cards is that they will go up +2 in rating for every win in their respective series. That means if they win the first round, they will be 99. So it's going to be a doozy. Also, if they actually win the round, each of their synergies will double, which is nuts when you consider that they all have four synergies. So this could potentially make some of them more valuable than the 99 Team of the Year cards that are out. But first, let's take a look at this Fire Master Set player item we got. The 99 Rod Brendamore, the Carolina Hurricane alum. Anytime that they do a card with fantastic card art like this that isn't just the cropped head, it's a win. And this card looks amazing. To grab him, you're going to require 20 Stanley Cup collectibles. There is a new collectible out. And it's not cheap. So just to take a quick look at them, they're around 40K tonight. When I did my set, I was able to get them for 37. And you're looking at about 700, a little bit around 700,000 coins to get them today. It's really no different than the 95 McDavid at Christmas. It all pretty much ends up being around 700K. And it's for a 99. So with all the cost of Team of the Years and whatnot, when we go and look at this card, you're going to see that it's not really all that much of an overpayment, but he is going to drop in price like all Master Set player items do. So let's go take a look at the card. So he's borderline pushing Mario and Wayne. He's almost a true 99 across the board. 2 to BU, 2 to FM. Finally, another good card that has good face-off rating. There isn't a lot when it comes to Team of the Year specifically, other than Mario and Wayne, and they're not Team of the Year. So it's good to have another centerman option like this. He's also big, and it's Rod Brendamore. This is just a sick card. I couldn't be happier with the selection. But first, we've got free stuff to grab. So if you go into the pack in the store, you'll notice this one pack at the very left. It's free. You crack it open, you're going to get some stuff. Now, this is mostly for players that are just starting the game, whether you just came back Team of the Year. So you're going to get a couple base guys and an 80 overall card from a different team. And again, those cards will upgrade +2 for every win they get. But Vegas isn't winning any games. Let's be real. Go Sharks. So if, like, you know, the world froze and Derek Englund won a few games, then he would go potentially up to an 88. But more importantly, you get those collectibles. So you start out with two free collectibles, which is dope. That's going to help towards that Rod Brendamore. So what we're going to do now, guys, is I'm going to run through all of the 30 cards that are released, the 91 overalls. There's no Columbus or Montreal, obviously, because they haven't clinched yet. I'm assuming they will be put into the game probably by Monday. So once we find out who is in, and currently New York is leading Columbus. Man, that would set up a crazy game tomorrow. So let's jump into the players. Let's start things off in Boston. I'm not going to give in-depth reviews of these guys, but we got the 91 Jake DeBrusk. Again, their synergies will double if they win the round. So if you think Boston is going to beat Toronto, he will get 2 to BU, 2 to MP, 2 to CS, and 2 to speed, and +8 to all of their stats. Then we also got the Torrey Krug. I will say this, for a defenseman, he's a little small, so just take that into account. On to Calgary, we got Derek Ryan. Again, a lot of these are cards they took advantage of them not having other higher overalls elsewhere, so you're going to see a lot of obscure ones. Then we also got Michael Backlund as well, representing the Flames. On to Carolina, the card I'm kind of interested in, the Michael Furland, 6'2", 206. He's going to have good shot and speed, obviously. They're all going to have max speed if they do make it. But again, it's tough. You're going to think Carolina is going to make it far in the first round. We also got Justin Williams, totally deserving. I mean, the Storm Surge alone should make him a 99. Colorado's is a little underwhelming, not for the players picked, but just that in Hut, they're not really going to be super useful. 5'10", 175 pounds. Kerfoot is a smaller player, which usually tends to not play as well in the game mode. We also got Samuel Girard, again, on defense, 5'10", 162 pounds. He does have BU, though, so. On to Dallas, and the one that you're hoping for, you're going to be a little disappointed. First, we got the 91 Alexander Radulov. Good card. I mean, there hasn't been another big one, so I'm glad that Radulov gets a chance to get a higher-end card. These wildcard teams have a chance, so they might pull off some wins. But then the other Dallas card is the Anton Khudobin. And come on, man. Just give us Bishop, man. We all just want Bishop. In Nashville, we got Philip Forsberg. So potentially you could replace that Christmas one if you've still got it. I do have to say this, though. All of the Western wildcard teams are all over the place on who they're going to play. So, and then we got Ryan Johansson. This is a big card. His faceoff is still a little low, even if they do win the first round and it goes up by +8. But he does have FM. This might be a really good card to grab if you're able to. On to the Islanders, we've got Brock Nelson. Again, another big card, does shoot left with Speedster, FB, PP. I mean, not one that I'm terribly excited about, but again, these are some more obscure cards. We also got Anders Lee. I'm glad that he got one as well. Let's see if the Islanders can impress in the first round. In Pittsburgh, it's a bit of a letdown. 91 Justin Schultz. I mean, you can't put Crosby, Malkin, Phil, or any of the bigger guys, but maybe Hornqvist, for example, or Murray even. And then the other 91, which makes no sense considering the Team of the Year card we got, is the 92 or the 91 Gensel. Like, I hate the double content. Can't really complain, but if you really liked Gensel and you think the Penguins will make it far in the first round or pull off some wins, you could get a better one than the Team of the Year comp season, but it just kind of makes the comp season card kind of useless. On to my Sharks. Logan Couture is the first one. Love this card. Will have it before the second round when he is a 99. Let's go, Sharks. And then the best one, I'm super happy. I voted for him a Community Team of the Year. We got Thomas Schertl. Glad that he had a fantastic season this year, and I'm super stoked he has the potential to get a 99 card. I mean, potential. I mean, come on. They're going on to the second round. Let's be real. Next, we've got St. Louis, 91, Braden Schenn, BU. Any of the BU cards are dope if they have a chance to win the first round, which St. Louis does, especially if they play Nashville. They've dominated Nashville, which is kind of surprising. But they have done well this year. Two to BU would be fantastic, and he's already a pretty good card. The other card for the Blues is David Perron. Yeah, I guess. Actually, I don't know. I mean, the Petrangelo got a 99, so, I mean, there isn't really... I mean, you can't put Tarasenko, so... Next, we've got Tampa, which is borderline lock city for winning the first round, no matter who they play. You got a potential at a 99 Tyler Johnson. I mean, they could have a ton of 99 cards by the time this is all said and done. He's a little bit smaller, so this is definitely a guy you put on the wing. It's not really a super exciting card, but again, if you're a Tampa fan, you can almost ice an entire 99 team, so that's pretty sick. And the other card for the Lightning is the absolute unit, Braden Coburn. This would be a great defense card when they win the first round. Doubled all the synergies, 99. I have a feeling this is going to go for a ton on the market. Following them, we got our Leafs. Kasperi Kapanen checks in. He's got BU, so that's already good. 6'1", 190 pounds. Shoots right, though. Not a ton of good right. Oh, there is quite a few good righties at this point in the game. But still, you're a Leafs fan, you're going to get Kapanen. And then Jake Gardner. Let's go. So hopefully the Leafs can survive and play a couple games. I don't really have much faith, though. Might as well skip over the Golden Knights as they are getting swept. So if you want a 91... Shea Theodore, be my guest. I mean, not really much point in investing in him, if you ask me. And the other one is a Paul Stastny, so kind of lame. I mean, who really likes Vegas, right? Like, seriously. Go Sharks. 91, Brett Connolly for the Washington Capitals. 6'3", 200 pounds, not a bad card. Does shoot right as well, which is, you know, a plus. Like I said, there's always more lefties than righties, but... Washington has a good chance to make it on, so you could have another 99 on your squad. You also get Dmitry Orlov. This is a pretty good card. He's a big boy, and 2 to BU potentially, so another good defenseman card that you could pick up. And lastly, potentially the best opportunity here, you've got the Winnipeg Jets getting a potential 99 fridge in Dustin Byfuglien. If this card gets a 99, that is going to be expensive. So if you pack him, do not sell him, in my opinion. I would hold, like, man, this could be probably one of the best cards. And then we got Jacob Trouba, who is also gigantic. So with BU and the potential to have two to BU, like, it would just be... It would just be very, very good. And, yeah, I would recommend keeping them. One thing I do want to mention, I always mention BU being an important one. I know everyone has a 99 speed at this point, but, guys, I don't know what it is. I have one of the best teams in Hutt this year, and when I take BU off my squad, maybe it's all in my head. I've said this all season. They just play slower. I don't know what it is, so I just make it mandatory to have BU on my team. Also, the more BU you have, you know, then the less requirement you do to have the head coach, so you could potentially just use it on another one to get another one of the team synergies like I do. Now, what's it going to cost you to get one of these playoff cards? These are ridiculously hard to pull, guys, unfortunately. Like, I'm looking right now. This is about 8 p.m., you're looking at like 700-800K before they even start showing up. They're going to drop in prices more and more come, especially ones, for example, like Dallas or you know, a Colorado even. I mean, although they're not really a lock to lose. It's tough. It is really tough because the only real team that is, you know, kind of a lock to move on, in my opinion, is Tampa, regardless of who they play. So those are the ones you got to watch out for. But right now they are expensive. But hey, I'm all about the content. Why don't we go and see if we can pull some, shall we? I'm sure we'll have great pack luck, right? Just a quick once-over of the probabilities. You want to make sure that you grab the ones that have the best chance at collectibles, to be honest. In my honest opinion, of pulling packs, because at least if you get the collectibles, then you make out with some coins, especially because the collectibles are going for like 40K right now. They'll drop, but with the playoff player cards being so rare, the only way to get them is to do the choice pack, and that's 18, so you know, they might not drop all that much, and the Rod Brendan Moore too. So let's pull some packs. Well, a solid 0-2 on the collectibles and no playoff cards. Yeah, we're let's just move on. So on to the next pack. Again, I'm doing the 1600 point ones. I'm just looking for collectibles at this point, guys. And bam, we grab a collectible. I'm sure the rest of the pack will be lit. Well, 1-4 in collectibles at least, so. One for five, 1-6 at like 87% chance to pull a collectible. Like, it's the brain pain, coach. Oh my goodness. Ugh. Holy smokes, we got a collectible. Just kidding. Oh my god. All right, last big pack we're gonna open. Like, at this point, I don't even know what to say. If the pack odds, like, that is some exquisite luck. I've pulled 2 out of a potential, like, 10 at 87% chance. Let's go try the other pack. I'm sure I'll have better chance here. All right, well, yeah, all right. Like, man, the packs this last month have been just devastating to me. My own fault, but whew. All right, so, I mean, we got some work to do. Basically, I was able to pull some, like, 2 collectibles plus the 2 that I got for free, which is a joke. So it looks like we've got an expensive trip to grab that Rod Brendamore, but let's go ahead and do it because that card looks sick. So after about 700K, I sold my beloved 95 Hut Champs Marlowe and was able to grab Rod Brendamore, who is going to slot in my second line center. The march for full 99s is in full effect. We're super close. But I'm not going to lie, this event is fantastic. The more and more that they make these cards coincide with what's happening in the real NHL is just good all around for the sport and for Hut, because it just increases engagement. You can go and you want to shoot your shot. I know throughout the week that whoever matches up with Tampa, those cards are going to be super cheap to grab at 91. And if they can pull off even a couple wins, you might be able to make some coins off them. And imagine they pulled off the upset. Like, imagine you invested in Tyler Johnson and or probably Braden Coburn because he's gigantic, and you lost money because they got knocked out. Like, that's the kind of stuff that's set up now because of this event, and I'm super stoked about it. And who knows? I mean, if this is just for the first round, it wouldn't stun me if there's something after and so forth. So, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video and the event. I'm NoSleeves12. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and like. I would appreciate it. Leave me your comments of what you think and the cards you're going to target. Have a good one, guys.